I am Vijay Kumar, MSc Mathematics and B.Ed. Today I am going to teach you the circles, introduction to the circles. So circle. Okay, what is a circle? Circle is a closed curve on all the points on the curve are equal distant from the center. Circle is a closed curve, all the points on the curve are equal distance from the center. If you take this point, that is equal distance from the center. Even that I call it as A. Even if I take B, even OB is also equal, OA is also equal. Even if I take C, OC is also equal. That means circle is a closed curve. All the points on the curve are equal distance from the center. Okay, that is a circle. Now, this Vaina circle, see this outer boundary. Outer boundary or perimeter of a circle is called circumference. The outer boundary of a circle, we will call it as circumference. Next, see, this is a circle. The outer boundary is a circumference. And this is the center, midpoint or center point. From this point to, from the center to the circumference, the distance between center to the circumference, this distance we will call it as radius of the circle. Radius, I take it as OA. See, OA is a radius. OA is a distance from the center to the circumference. Next, I'll write one more circle. Yeah, see, is a center. When we join two line joins two points on the circumference and passes through the center. See, this AB is a one point and B is a one more point. This AB line is joining two points on the circumference and passes through the center. So this line we will call it as diameter. Diameter is a line which joins two points on the circumference and passes through the center. And see here, this is the radius. Even here, OA is a radius and OB is also radius. So in a diameter, we have two radius. So diameter is always 2 times the radius. Okay. The diameter is the radius plus radius, we will get 2 times the radius. Next is a circle. And see here, this is a center. A line joins, AB is a line. Line joins 2 points on the circumference, but it is not passing through the center. This line, just we will call it as a chord. A chord is a line which joins 2 points on the circumference. Any 2 points on the circumference here need not to pass through the center. So just it joins 2 points on the circumference. Even diameter also joins 2 points on the circumference. So even AB, the diameter is also a chord. So diameter is the biggest chord in a circle. Okay, next. See, this AB is a chord. And see, that AB chord divides the circle into two parts. So this one and this one. This smaller part, the area surrounded by chord and an arc. Now arc, what is an arc? Arc is a part of the circumference. If you take the whole boundary, we'll call it as circumference. If you take the part of that boundary, we'll call it as arc. This is arc and this is the chord. So the area surrounded by chord and arc is called segment. The area the surrounded by chord and an arc is called segment. If it is smaller area, we'll call it as minor segment. See, here this is the minor segment and this is a big larger area. This is called as major segment. Major segment. Then the larger area. So again I'll repeat, the area surrounded by chord and arc is called as segment. If it is a smaller area, we'll call it as a minor segment. If it is a larger area, we'll call it as a major segment. Same in a circle. If I take two radii, one is OA is one radii and OB is another radius. So totally we have, here we have two radii and an arc. This area, the area surrounded by two radii and an arc, this area we will call it as sector. Here segment is area surrounded by chord and an arc, but sector is area surrounded by two radii and an arc. If the smaller area, we will call it as minor sector, whereas the larger area, we will call it as major sector. So here there is a difference between segment and sector. Segment is area surrounded by chord and an arc, whereas sector is area surrounded by two radii and an arc. Okay, the smaller area will call it as a minor sector, and the larger area will call it as a major sector. Okay, next, in a circle, if a line just touches the circle at a point, at point P, a line just touches the circle at a point, then this line we will call it as tangent. Tangent is a line touches the circle at a point. Whereas, see, in this circle, the line is passing through the circle. The line is passing through the circle. This line, we will call it as secant. So, secant means the line which passes through the circle, whereas tangent will just touches the circle at a point. Okay, now, this is the center, and I will join this center to that point where that tangent is meeting. This tangent and the radii, where both are meeting at a point of contact. This point where the tangent and circle is meeting is called as point of contact. See, always the tangent and the radius join at a point of contact, always perpendicular to each other. Okay. Thank you.